Hey there. Are you using a smaller GPU with just 8 to 12 gigabytes of memory? Have you ever wanted to generate high-quality images like Flux 1Dev, but your low VRAM held you back? Well, this video is for you. I was able to generate this image using a small Q3 GGUF model. To begin, let me first update the program using the update bat file. Also, update it from the comfyUI manager. I made a video a few months ago on Wan 2.1 and used Wan model to generate videos. However, the Wan 2.1 model generates images similar to the Flux 1Dev 24GB model. This is the default workflow in comfyUI for text-to-image generation. I will be using the GGUF model. So, in the comfyUI manager, and then to the custom node manager. Search for GGUF. This comfyUI GGUF is needed for the unit models. Install the nightly version of this node. Restart and reload the comfyUI. Now I will search for unit. This unit loader will load the GGUF model. Next, I need the clip loader for GGUF models. Now this checkpoint node is not required. I need this VAE connection as well. I will search for the VAE. This will replace the VAE from the checkpoint node. Now I can delete this node. I will make the connection for the model. And then the clip loader with the prompt node. At last will be the VAE. The three nodes added will need some files to make this workflow produce an image. I have all the links in this notepad, and I will be sharing the same in the video description. These are the GGUF models I will be using. The smallest Q3 model is around 7 gigabytes. I think this should also work even on a 6 gigabyte card. Let me know in the comments if any of you are trying with a 6 gigabyte card. It may help someone. Download the file and keep it inside the models folder, and then in the unit folder. I will download some others as well for testing. The larger the model, more memory will be occupied for generating an image. Next, I will get the clip encoder. These are the GGUF encoders needed in the workflow. I got the encoder corresponding to the unit I have downloaded. Save the encoder inside the models and then in the text encoder folder. The third file is the VAE, which is inside these folders. This is the VAE. Download it and save it inside the models and then the VAE folder. Press the letter R to refresh the files downloaded just now. Select the files and the nodes. I will start with the smaller Q3 model. And then select the clip encoder. The model type is Wan. I will increase the size of this empty latent. This empty latent is like a canvas on which the image is generated. The steps can be between 10 to 15. CFG should be around 1. The sampler is Euler, and the scheduler will be beta. Now the workflow should work. I will queue the workflow to process. It took around 10 seconds for one step, and there are a total of 10 steps. The 16 gigabyte memory looks full because it is not using the shared memory. I am sure this Q3 model will work on an 8 gigabyte card. I doubt it will work on a 6 gigabyte card. It may work with a shared memory. The image was generated in 163 seconds. It is not impressive. I forgot to add a LoRa in the workflow. I will search for the load LoRa node and have it connected between the unit and clip loader. I will share the link to the LoRa. You can download the LoRa from here. Keep it inside the models and then the LoRa folder. Not all the LoRa are going to work. This light X2V distill should work. Refresh by pressing the letter R, select the distilled or the cause video LoRa, and then run the workflow. After 120 seconds, I got the result. and it looks like it has been improved. I will try another LoRa. And I got the result after 120 seconds. This is a high-quality image. What do you think? I will change the prompt and add some keywords for the negative prompt. The image generated looks extremely clear. The smaller Q3 models are capable of generating very promising images. I will make the seed fixed and will generate the image using the distilled LoRa to check the difference. So, this is the image from the distilled LoRa. Now changing it to cause video LoRa. And this is the image by cause video LoRa. I think the distilled LoRa works better. This can be subjective. You can get a few more LoRa from Hugging Face. If you're going to try another LoRa, then first get the LoRa having rank 32 in their names. It worked most of the time. I tried a few images with different styles using the distilled LoRa. The prompts I'm using are from Blackbox AI. The images generated were so good, they made me stop and stare for a moment. This image was generated using a prompt from Civet AI, and later, I modified the prompt. I tried adding my style and preference, but it made the image less interesting. You can always use GPT for prompts if you are like me. While searching for a prompt on the internet, I found this workflow, which looks better, and I think this workflow will increase the quality of our image. A few more nodes will be installed after the comfyUI GGUF node I did at the beginning of this video. In the missing node, I got this error, but let's continue and hope it works. Restart and reload the program. I think I do not need to share my simple workflow. Instead, this looks better. These two nodes are extra. Here and on the right, these are the extra. I copied the seed ID and prompt from my workflow of the same orange rover on Mars that you saw just now. Then I tried running the workflow. I got the image, the empty latent size was different, but the image looked good. I will quickly duplicate the node for landscape images and generate it again. The landscape image looks great. I do not know if you can see it, but there is a grain effect on the image. It looks good. I will disable this node. The seed is fixed. I will generate again. The image became smoother. You must try this and see for yourself. My videos are upscaled to 4K, and these minor details may get lost. I tried the Q6 models compared to Q3. This is noticeably better. I tried using Q8 for both UNet and Clip Encoder. As expected, the image looks too good. I kept the same prompt and seed ID, used the Q3 UNet and Q4 Encoder, which took a few extra seconds more than the Q8 model. After taking 30 more seconds, the Q3 model gives the result, which is not bad. I may be wrong, but I think the Q8 seems to be of the same quality as the 24GB Flux model. Well, if we speak about Flux, then we must also consider the prompt adherence in terms of text and image. My prompt was simple, a text, go away, carved into a tree trunk. The model used is Q3, and it failed. Then I tried with the Q8 model. I got the text, but this is not a tree trunk. At last, I tried generating humans with a simple prompt. I did not describe the skin or details, but the image looks fine. The Q3 UNet and Q4 Encoder have good results. I can certainly say the skin looks better than the Flux models. I tried again for a landscape image. Image by Q3 model looks incredible. I will try the same with Q8 model. The image looks realistic to me, captured by DSLR camera. What are your thoughts on this? If we exclude the text in the image generation, this will be my choice with the Flux Q8 model. Or should it be over the Flux Q8 model? Let me know your thoughts.